fairly and impartially between the parties. And you need to have a solid evidence that yes, criminal did not act fairly and impartially. Or there is an uncertainty or ambiguity in the award. Or the award has been obtained by fraud or being contrary to the public policy of the state. The another round of challenging the award is on the question of law. If award involves a serious question of law, then you can always challenge the award. This is section 69 of the English Application Act. You cannot go to the court straight away. The appeal can be filed only after taking the leave of the court. You have to take the prior permission of the court. And for the purpose of taking leave, you have to move your application within 28 days from the date of the publication of the award. These are given, but normally they are not allowed because English courts respect draft application awards. And once that process is exhausted, that award becomes final and good for enforcement in India. Enforceability of DAFTA arbitration awards. DAFTA arbitration awards are enforceable in more than 170 countries. It is rather 176 countries on the basis of New York Convention. New York Convention is very old, the way back in 1958. India is also a signatory to New York Convention. And on that basis, DAFTA arbitration awards are enforceable in India. This enforcement has earlier been a problematic task for the foreign parties, because if any foreign party who was having in his hand a DAFTA arbitration award, he was finding extremely difficult to enforce this award in India. But particularly with the amendments in the Arbitration Act, recently with effect from 23rd October 2015, arbitration enforcement of arbitration awards, the international arbitration awards, has become far more easier and far more quicker, because the definition of the court has been changed. Court means the High Court, not the Civil Court. Earlier, suppose if you are residing in Kanpur and there was an arbitration award against you, then the enforcement application was to be submitted to the highest civil court, which is a civil court or a session court, whatever it is. And then you have a long process because there is a lot of conflict with the civil courts and the award does not dispose of it 10 years. And by that time, the other party gets totally frustrated. Now, situation has changed. The application for enforcement will be filed. Remember, you are asking me a question whether it is a suit or it is a case. It is basically an application for enforcement. The application for enforcement will be filed in the High Court. And you can challenge that application for enforcement. The challenge will be that court should not allow the enforcement. Now, what is the basis of challenge? Challenge can be only on the ground of public policy. I will deal this later on. And that public policy has been also defined in recent Arbitration Amendment Act. So there are very limited grounds of challenge, but therefore normally after arbitration awards, particularly in view of the recent amendment, they would be enforceable. Court can refuse enforcement if such enforcement would be contrary to public policy in India. Now, what is public policy?